Kacey here. Luna's got a bug of some sort, so I'm on my way to get her some medicine and a pizza. She wants the pizza. But today's video is all about the software update 2020.4.1. There's a lot of... It has a lot of effects that are different on each car, so I'm going to include a link to Test Lucky for MCU1 cars, Tesla Canuck for Canadian Model 3s, and then we're going to get done with the Hardware 3 full self-driving Model X. So, the only real changes that that I haven't covered already in the previously recorded segments for this quick preview is when coming upon a on-ramp where you're actually using the on-ramp to get onto the highway, not one where you're passing and the car wants to sometimes veer to the right depending on what speed you're going, is that the car is better than I am at merging onto the highway when people are being jerks and they don't want to let you in. So let's jump into it. I've discovered a seafood restaurant or seafood supply store. Either way, Luna loves seafood, so we're gonna check it out and see if it's her style. Then we're gonna go get her medicine and the pizza. Okay, we have the medication. Next up is the free pizza. Fuel pump, eh? It's not free for any sort of sponsorship or anything. We had coupons. So let's get us a, not necessarily good, but definitely free pizza. She might actually enjoy that seafood restaurant, but it's not what she was looking for. So the next thing we're gonna do is do what I do with all smelly food, pizza. Put it in the front trunk, seafood included. But we didn't get any of that today. It's dirty. The problem is I need to find a car wash that is non-touch, and those are scarce here in Northern Virginia. They've all been replaced with the wash tunnels and full service, and I can wash my own car if I was going full service. Good morning, Kacey here. We've got update 2020.4.1 incoming. I'll see you when it finishes. I don't normally do this before driving, but let's go ahead and install this update. This is something that's new since the last time I sat in the car for an update. It's not new to this build that I'm on. It's been around for a couple months now. This is a bit better than I anticipated. It actually tells you what it's doing if you happen to be sitting in the car during the update. So right now it's updating Autopilot. So let's see what's new with Autopilot after this. I forgot how many weird noises, clicks and pops and fan whirrings and... Yeah, like that. These things make when they update. So if you've never sat through a update inside the car, you'll get a bunch of just random error messages and stuff as systems go offline and update. And yeah, this is what you get. This is what you get. So nothing to be alarmed with, unless they persist after the car says that it's done. This update is exactly as I anticipated. We get the additional vehicle information, and then everything else is the same as before. Yeah, so everything else is the same as before, but we should be able to see now. Some stats about the car. So I don't even know where they keep that, so let's take a look. All right, we're gonna reset trip B because there's a new software update. Our last one was about 1,000 miles ago. We burned 363 kilowatt hours at a measly 421 watt hours per mile. Let's reset trip B. Let's view additional information regarding the configuration of vehicle by tapping controls, software, additional vehicle information. Reading is fundamental, folks. Additional vehicle information. All right, so my air suspension type is standard. Audio system is premium. There's my IMEI virtual. I don't know. Cold weather package, a steering wheel and wiper heaters. The garage door opener is HomeLink version 5, option 2. And the motors are induction. So the front is induction and the rear is induction large and the tow package is included. So as you can tell, I don't have a Raven car. And that's all that you can see on this update. So next up is to drive the car and see if it behaves any differently on autopilot. We're also looking at the quarterly stock results today, so I'm going to listen to that while I drive home. So there probably won't be a summary on this drive, probably closer to when I go pick Luna up from work and go charge the vehicle. So we'll catch you on the flip side. I just finished filming the Tesla Life and What Drives Us shows, and it looks like the car no longer... Yeah, there we go. It no longer has issues coming on line when starting up at a parking garage. The reason those cones blinked like that was because one of my neighbors actually passed by the cones, and so the car could no longer see them. So that is a welcome change. The previous behavior since the introduction of the full self-driving preview was that the autopilot camera would not actually activate until I had left the parking garage for quite some time, as seen in some other videos where I mentioned it. But now, you start to drive, and the camera system is running. Or I guess it was always running, but now it's matched. So as we come up to these cones here, oh, it made a liar of me. All right, so at least it's working when it's parked. So the preview, the full self-driving preview came back at the same point where it has typically been back in the past. Usually by the time I get to that first stop sign in the neighborhood, it is ready to go. And that was the case here as well, except that it did actually function for a little while in the parking garage. The car turning animation is slightly different. When it's on that bigger view, it's much clearer. Like I said, this is a rather minor interview, but or interview, a rather minor update, but there's still changes. Intriguing. So the battery preconditioning behavior has finally gone back to what it was after Tesla introduced the battery preconditioning feature. I didn't see the notification, but now that we've arrived at the supercharger, as we were backing into the stall, you heard a burst from the heater and the pump and the fan that are involved in that battery heating system. They did turn off and we stopped moving, but I'm guessing that just means that it was right where it wanted to be. So now we're gonna plug in and I'll let you know if I notice anything different, particularly if the charging text size has returned to normal from where they shrunk it several updates ago. Okay, so the text size has not increased and, unable to DC fast charge, supercharge, disconnect and retry. Luna's getting right place, Stardew Valley. You're gonna play your game, right? Huh? You play your game, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Luna's gonna play Stardew Valley. Blue. All right, we heard a click in the cabinet. We're not sharing with anybody because we're on 2A. 2B is empty. We might have to go down to 3. See what happens. Sometimes at this particular location, it takes a while to handshake, so we'll see. Usually though, oh, red. Yeah, usually though, if you hear the cabinet click, it's not an issue. Just trying again. So that one time at Laurel, you haven't seen this video yet, but at the Laurel supercharger, it sat there and retried a bunch of times and it worked, but why do that? Well, we could just move over a stall. Okay, and just in case it was the cabinet, we went ahead and moved over to cabinet 3. That cable's a lot less stiff, so somebody was able to use it recently. And I say stiff because it's cold out. It's 37 degrees right now, Fahrenheit. Alright, there's another click from the cabinet, and we're green! Alright, so let's play some Stardew Valley there, Luna.
And we'll catch you on the flip side.
Okay, we're almost done with our preview of the new software update 2020.4.1. And so far the results have been mixed. It does feel like a minor update, unless you're in China or if you're on MCU1. Both of those groups got major updates with this update. But we're gonna just go on some more errands today, and then I will come back with my final findings on Hardware 3 and someone who's coming from the holiday updates for 2019. Our experience with the new 2020 update, it's version 10.2, build 2020.4.1 for full self-driving cars. It's been a mixed bag, nothing bad. At low speeds while using full self-driving, the car makes some questionable moves, particularly if the lane suddenly gets wider, say you're passing an on-ramp. At high speeds, if you're passing it on ramp, it does a much better job. It still moves over, but it doesn't move over anywhere near as much. About like what it would do when it's moving over for a semi-truck or other large vehicle. The interaction with bad drivers in rush hour traffic is incredible. It's come up greatly from previous versions, and it doesn't get... Well, I don't know if it's getting confused or not, but it meshes with the other drivers much better. And even when it wants to abort a lane change, the it still whips you back and forth. But something about the way that it's doing it is... I haven't had anybody try and be aggressive to the car when it does the double back move. They actually hang back and wait to see what's happening. And so at that point, it gives the car enough room and time to actually complete the maneuver. So, like I said, it's a minor update for anybody who's coming from the holiday update and either Autopilot 2.5 with MCU2 or full self-driving with MCU... Well, yeah, you'd only have full self-driving with MCU2 right now. But it's also a major update for anybody in China or anybody coming from a much older update on MCU1 because they finally get all the stuff that we got for the Christmas holiday. So... With that, I want to ask you to please subscribe to this channel, leave a comment down below, and if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, and we'll catch you on the flip side, hopefully with a much more substantial video, or much more substantial update, hey, every update's nice to have, so catch you on the flip side. If I have time, we're going to go ahead and try and do a separate video to see if there were any updates to the Smart Summon feature, because the car took about 20 minutes to complete all of its updates, so there had to have been something in it other than it. What I noticed so far with the way it behaves in traffic and the way it doesn't behave at low speed with weird lane geometries. So, depending on weather and time, like I said, look for that coming in a future video. So if you've rung the bell, you'll get a notification when that happens, and I've uploaded it. So we'll catch you on the flip side. While this was a minor update for me, I did appreciate all the Autopilot full self-driving tweaks, and the ability to know what hardware the car thinks is installed is also really nice. It's a good small update, and it went out pretty quickly. 2018. It went out pretty quickly. 2020.4.1 means that it was from the fourth week of January of this year, so good on you for coming back from the holidays, Tesla. And we'll catch you on the next one.